Hello and welcome all. Today we will learn about why mesons have to be made up of quark antiquark pair. Why mesons have to be made up of a quark antiquark pair. As we all know, hadrons are subdivided into two parts. The first one is mesons and the second is baryons. Mesons are the bosons having integer spin. Whereas baryons are the fermions having half integer spin. Mesons have to be made up of a quark antiquark pair. Can be proved by following two ways. The first one is by considering the color charge. And the second one is by considering the baryon number. First, we will start with considering the color charge. Quarks have a property called color charge. Only combinations of quarks that have zero net color charge are possible states in standard model and in nature. Also, according to QCD, that is quantum chromodynamics, QCD theory, bound states of quarks must have no color, that means they have to be colorless. There are total three color charges. The first one is red. The second one is blue. And the third one is green. There are total four possibilities for having net zero color charge. Total four possibilities for net zero color charge, that is for to be colorless. They are as follows. First one is red plus blue plus green color charge gives colorless, that is zero net charge. Then the second one is क्वार्क ऑफ रेड प्लस एंटी क्वार्क ऑफ रेड गिव्स कलरलेस. द थर्ड पॉसिबिलिटी इज क्वार्क ऑफ ब्लू प्लस एंटी क्वार्क ऑफ ब्लू गिव्स कलरलेस. Whereas the fourth possibility is quark of green plus anti-quark of green gives colorless, that is zero net color charge. As we all know, the quarks are the fermions, so combination of quark and anti-quark will give us boson, whereas the combination of three quarks will give fermion. As we know, mesons are bosons, so mesons have to be a quark and an antiquark pair. Also, we can say that mesons are color charge neutral, that is, they are colorless. And finally, we conclude that mesons are a quark antiquark pair. Let us revise what we have done. First, we started with why mesons have to be made up of a quark and antiquark pair. So there were two ways by which we can prove this. First was considering the color charge, and second was considering the baryon number. First, we started the considering the color charge. In that, we told that quarks have a property known as color charge, and only those combination of quarks are possible that have zero net color charge in standard model and in nature. And also, according to QCD theory, that is quantum chromodynamics, bound states of quarks must have to be colorless, that is, they have no color. There are total three types of color charges: red, blue, and green. So we have the four possibilities for net zero color charge, and they are as follows. First is red charge plus blue plus green gives colorless. The second is quark of red color charge and second plus antiquark of red color charge gives colorless. The third possibility is quark of blue plus antiquark of blue results into the colorless. And the fourth one is quark of green plus antiquark of green results into colorless. We know that quarks are fermions, so combination of a quark and antiquark will result into a boson, whereas combination of three quarks will result into a fermion. As we know, mesons are the bosons, so they have to be a quark and antiquark pair. Mesons are color charge neutral, and finally we proved by considering the color charge that mesons are quark antiquark pair. Now we will start by considering the baryon number. Considering baryon number. We know there are 6 quarks and 6 antiquarks. First of all, quarks are up, down, charm, strange, top, and bottom. The charge for up charm and top is plus 2/3 E. Whereas the charge for down, strange and bottom is minus 1/3 E, where E is the charge of electron. And the baryon number is 1/3 for all the 6 quarks. Antiquarks are U bar, D bar, C bar, S bar, T bar and B bar. The charge for U bar, C bar and T bar is minus 2/3 E, and the charge for D bar, S bar and B bar is plus 1/3 E. And the baryon number for all the 6 antiquarks is minus 1/3. Baryon number for baryons is 1. Whereas baryon number for mesons is 0. Now we will calculate the baryon number by considering the different combinations of quarks. First case, let us suppose that mesons are made up of two quarks, that is U and D. That is up and down. So we can say the quark structure will be UD, and then we calculate the baryon number for this combination. As we know, the baryon number for both the quarks is 1/3 each. So here baryon number will become 1/3 plus 1/3 equals to 2/3. But baryon number should not be equal to 2/3 for mesons, it should be equal to 0. So baryon number is equal to 2/3, not possible for mesons, as B is not equal to 0. Mesons are not made up of two quarks. So we can say the combination of meson to be U and D is not possible. The second case is, let us suppose mesons are made up of two antiquarks. That is U bar and D bar, that is up antiquark and D antiquark. So the quark structure of mesons will become U bar, D bar. Now we calculate the baryon number for this combination. Baryon number for antiquark is minus 1/3. So minus 1/3, minus 1/3 is minus 2/3. But baryon number is equals to minus 2/3 for mesons is not possible. As B, that is baryon number, is not equals to 0, mesons are not made up of two antiquarks. The third case is, let us suppose that mesons are made up of a quark and an antiquark pair. that is quark U and antiquark D. Up quark and down antiquark. So the baryon number, so the quark structure will become U D bar. Now we calculate the baryon number for this quark structure. The baryon number for quarks is 1 upon 3, whereas the baryon number for antiquark is minus 1 upon 3, resulting into a 0 baryon number. Baryon number is 0 for mesons. So here, as B equals to 0, as baryon number is equals to 0, we can say that mesons are made up of quark and antiquark pair. In order to prove that mesons have to be made up of quark-antiquark pair, there were two ways. First, we started with considering the color charge, and then second was considering the baryon number. In considering the baryon number, we first started with the quarks and antiquarks, their charge and baryon number. We can see that baryon number for quarks is 1 upon 3, whereas baryon number for antiquarks is minus 1 upon 3. Baryon number for baryons is 1, whereas baryon number for mesons is 0. We started with different cases and taking the different combinations of quarks. In first case, we suppose that mesons are made up of two quarks, that is up and down. So the baryon number becomes 2 upon 3. But baryon number is equals to 2 upon 3 is not possible for mesons. So we can say as B is not equals to 0, mesons are not made up of two quarks. Then the second case was that we suppose mesons are made up of two antiquarks, that is U bar and D bar. So the quark structure was U bar D bar, and the baryon number was found to be minus 2 upon 3. But baryon number is minus 2 upon 3, not possible for mesons. So as B is not equals to 0, mesons are not made up of two antiquarks. Then we started with the third case, that is mesons are made up of a quark and antiquark pair, that is U D bar. Then the baryon number was found to be 0. Baryon number is equals to 0 is possible for mesons. So we can say as baryon number is 0, mesons are made up of a quark and antiquark pair. Friends, I have uploaded a video for the topic difference between bosons and fermions, classification of fundamental forces and fundamental particles. Please go through these videos and have better understanding about the elementary physics. I have uploaded a second video for different topic, different types of quarks, antiquarks, concept of isospin, brief description about leptons, hadrons, mesons and baryons. Also go through this video to understand the topic in detail. Don't forget to subscribe my channel for more videos on high energy particle physics. Thank you.